have for this, which will make you a good civil servant?
Sir, I think throughout my life I have developed certain qualities. One of it being determination towards a particular cause. Secondly, sir, I think dedication is one of my quality. Third is being honest. Fourth is being passionate about whatever work I'm doing. So these are the qualities that I will bring.
Good. I presume this is your first attempt because you passed in 2018.
Yes, sir.
Correct?
Yes, sir.
You introduced the constitution to us, and we are not agents here. You are a diplomat.
So I have to introduce Indian constitution. Sir, as a diplomat, I would introduce to the normal people of other countries Indian constitution by talking first about the preamble of our constitution with the starting words like we the people. So I will talk about that. I will tell them about some of the basic features that are present in our preamble like liberty, equality, etc. Then sir, I will talk of certain other features of our constitution like it is the longest written constitution of the world. It has more than 400 articles. I will talk about some of the important amendments that have been done in it. I will also tell them what kind of fundamental rights do the citizens of India have and certain unique features like, for instance, the directive principles, which are not present in constitution of many countries, fundamental duties. So this is what I will broadly tell.
So, why do you think is our, you said it is bulky, why do you think it has become bulky?
Sir, I think there are many reasons for it. One of the primary reasons being that the Indian constitution has been written for a large amount of population, seeing the fact that we are such a vast country. Secondly, sir, we have only one constitution for the center as well as for the states, unlike certain countries like America, where every state also have their constitution. And thirdly, I also think, sir, that the fact that the constituent assembly was dominated by lawyers, so that also made the constitution a little bit bulky.
If I say that one provision slightly tilts the balance of towards the judiciary, in favor of the judiciary, when it comes to exercise of powers by all three organs, which provision would you talk about?
Sir, I think Article 142 of the Constitution, which gives the Honorable Supreme Court the power to do complete justice on any of the case. So I think that tilts the balance more towards judiciary.
Okay. Judicial review? What is judicial review?
Sir, judicial review means that the judiciary has the power to review any of the law or act or any rule made by the executive or even the legislature.
Okay, how do you promote India's case as a permanent member of the UN Security Council?
Sir, firstly, sir, I will talk about the requirement of India to be in the United Nations Security Council. Primarily, I would say that India as a country has a very rich civilization. I will talk about how in the ancient past we have been witness to one of the most older civilization of the world, that is the Indus Valley civilization. Secondly, sir, I will talk about...
So Rome should also... Because of Rome, Italy should also be in the United Nations Security Council. So it has an older history.
Sir, that is one.
Italia.
Sir, that is one reason. And sir, apart from that, I think India has many other things which I would prefer.
Okay, terrorism. What are the laws and institutions in India to deal with terrorism?
Sir, we do not have a dedicated law to deal with terrorism, but there are other laws. For instance, we have the National Security Act, the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act, which can be used. And when it comes to institutions, sir, we have National Investigation Agency, NIA. Then even other institutions like CBI also to some extent can be involved. The local polices are also there.
Do we have an agreement over definition of terrorism good atmosphere?
Unfortunately, sir, we do not have an agreement, because what a particular group or a particular person may be a terrorist for some country, but it may end up becoming a freedom fighter.
Okay, last. What is the latest status on India-Pakistan dispute before ICJ?
Sir, at the ICJ, both India and Pakistan have put forward their views on the Kulbhushan Yadav case. And so currently, I am not aware of what has happened.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Vaibhav.
Yes, sir.
Vaibhav and Sunil, which is your first name?
Sir, my first name is Vaibhav and Sunil is my father's name.
This is a Maharashtrian way of writing.
Yes, sir.
Tell me, political science and international relations. You also take interest in reading articles on foreign policy.
Yes, sir.
CPEC. Okay. Yes. China, Pakistan.
Economic
Corridor. How much China is investing?
So, the exact number I'm not aware, but can I make an intelligent guess?
Okay.
I think around $30 to $40 billion.
No. Earlier it was slated something like $54 billion. Now it is touching $60 billion. Anyway, so why China is investing so much money on this corridor? What is the strategic importance to China?
So from historic times, China has faced a problem which is called as Malacca dilemma. That more than 80% of their energy imports come from the Malacca Strait. And that is the only major route that they have. So if they are developing the China-Pakistan economic corridor, they get an advantage that directly from the Gulf countries, they can use the CPEC and reach China. So they can in one way deal with the
Malacca. So it shortens the distance and they can get rid of this Malacca dilemma?
So not completely rid, but to some extent, their dependence on the Malacca Strait will reduce. And sir, apart from that, CPEC will also help them to enhance their influence in Central Asia and in the larger Eurasian region. So that is the reason why they are promoting it.
Have you heard the term string of pearls?
Yes, sir.
What is it?
Sir, the idea of string of pearls was first given by America in one of their energy documents. So this particular theory says that China is building a string of ports in and around the Indian Ocean region, primarily to in one way counter India and keep it in South Asia itself. For instance, they have built a port at Wadar in Pakistan, one port is in Sri Lanka, one is in Bangladesh, the Chittagong port. So in this way, sir, they are building a network of ports. And India's apprehension is that China is doing it to counter India and keep it in South Asia itself.
In South Asia. Okay. Hobbes, you have it? Thomas Hobbes?
Yes, sir, I have.
You know, he is the most influential exponent of sovereignty, absolute sovereignty.
Yes.
Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
He is also said to be champion of individualism.
Yes, sir.
How do you reconcile this? You get my point?
Yes, sir. I got your point. So, we can see both individualism as well as the absolutism in him. However, sir, I think that Hobbes is more individualist. In the sense that though he talks...
No, he pleaded for absolute sovereignty. He said that, you know, there is no doubt about it. But at the same time, he is also champion of individualism. How could you reconcile?
Sir, for that, we need to go to the times when Hobbes was living.
Hmm.
So, when he was living in England, that was the time when wars were happening on the basis.
No, that is okay. But then, what is the reason?
Sir, the primary reason is that Hobbes has defined the individual in such a way that he says that man is guided more by passion. And because of that, when man lives in a state of nature, the success of one man is actually going to create a sense of insecurity for another man. So the state of nature is going to be a state of war of all with all. And this is going to affect the progress, stability.
So in the state of nature, he considers or he regards the individual's safety as the utmost important. Because he said, in the state of nature they were
in a state of war.
State of war and poor, nasty, brutish and short.
Yes, sir.
That is why for their safety and security, absolute sovereignty is
yes.
essential. No, that is how he justifies. Okay. Tell me, you have heard about the Smart India scheme, the project?
Sir, are you talking about smart cities?
Smart cities. Correct. The smart cities. Why smart cities? Why not smart rural areas? Because most of the people are living in rural areas.
Sir, actually we need both smart cities and smart villages.
Hmm. But we are now spending more on the smart cities.
Yes, sir. Now we are spending more because smart cities provide the fact that the future of India lies in its cities, seeing the fact that our urban population is increasing on a very large scale.
What is the urban population now?
Sir, as per 2011 census, it was around 32%, and now perhaps it would be around 40%. Maybe in the next census we'll get the numbers.
Hmm.
So, sir, smart cities are important because cities have become the center of economic growth in today's time.
Hmm.
And the fact that so many people are now living in cities, it is important to provide them a good standard of life.
Correct.
Otherwise,
cities... So, what is being done in the smart cities?
Sir, I'm not exactly aware about the components, but from my experience of Pune, because I come from Pune...
No. You have not read about smart cities?
Sir, I do not know the exact details. But sir, under that, we are doing some schemes on lightning.
There are so many aspects of it. Read up. To have a full knowledge. Okay, thank you.
So, you talked about smart cities because there's going to be a big urban population.
Yes, ma'am.
So, they're moving from the rural area, migrations are taking place.
Yes, ma'am.
Why do migrations take place?
Ma'am, migration take place because of a number of reasons.
Mm-hmm.
Two primary are push factors and pull factors. So,
are you aware of the Rohingya problem?
Yes, ma'am.
Why are they migrating to different areas?
Ma'am, Rohingyas are primarily migrating because they are a Muslim minority in a Buddhist-dominated Myanmar.
Hmm.
And they have been suffering religious persecution by the Myanmarese authorities. So, that is primarily the reason they are migrating now.
So, we have some of them in India also?
Yes,
which
ma'am.
Are the centers that they have their refugee camps?
Ma'am, primarily in India, they are settled in the area near Bangladesh border, India-Bangladesh border. And
Indian cities?
Ma'am, exactly, I do not.
Hyderabad, Jammu and a city in UP. Okay, you're from Pune.
Yes.
The national games were held in Pune. Are you aware last year they were held in Pune? The national games, youth national games?
No, ma'am. But ma'am, recently Khelo India had...
That's what I meant, Khelo India Games.
Yes.
So, what was the objective of holding these games?
Ma'am, the primary objective of Khelo India is to instill the sense of sports spirit among the individuals. Because seeing the fact that nowadays youths are focusing more on the academics part and sports have got neglected.
Was it also to see our talent so that we could prepare them for future games like the Olympics?
Yes, ma'am. It was for that also, and around rupees 8 lakh will be given for the winners of it.
Alright. Now, you participated in boat games. What was this?
Ma'am, regatta is primarily a boat game that happens in my College of Engineering, Pune, every year. And
so, where is it? You have some sea there? You don't have a sea there?
Ma'am, we have a Mulamutha River in Pune.
Alright. So, this is a race?
No, ma'am, it is not a race. There are basically 4 or 5 games happening there, like telly matches, punt, rowing.
So, did you need some training to take part in this regatta?
Yes, ma'am. We trained for around 3 to 4 months, and there were 5 mentors who were our seniors only who trained us.
Alright. Now, since you're from Maharashtra, one hears of farmers' distress.
Yes.
And also, lots of farmers and tribals marched to Pune. They were stopped there and it is said their demands were met. What were their demands?
Ma'am, recently farmers had migrated to Pune because of sugar.
Hmm.
That many of the farmers were not getting a good price for their sugar which they had cultivated.
Hmm.
So, Now, because of the farmer protests, the government of Maharashtra has decided to give farmers.
But there are also tribals along with the farmers. What do they want?
Ma'am, the tribals actually, they were going to Mumbai.
Hmm.
And their primary demand was the proper implementation of Forest Rights Act.
What is the Forest Rights Act?
Ma'am, Forest Rights Act was an act passed by the Indian Parliament in 2016. And this act provides certain amount of rights to the
tribes. What are these rights?
Some of the rights, ma'am, are that the tribals will be given a share in the minor forest produce.
And what, give me examples of minor forest produce?
I'm not aware. Honey,
tenduli, all these? Okay. Now, it's also said that in Maharashtra, the LWE, left-wing extremism, is more or less concentrated in the tribal areas. Is that correct?
Yes, ma'am. In Maharashtra, left-wing extremism is primarily in three districts of East Maharashtra, that is Gondia, Gadchiroli, and in and there is one more.
Chandra,
yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay. So why is it that we see LWE only more or less in the tribal areas? Any particular reason?
Ma'am, primarily, if we see left-wing extremism in Maharashtra is an offshoot of the left-wing extremism found in Andhra and Telangana.
Okay, but I'm only talking about your state. What is the reason?
Ma'am, more or less, it's the reason of development deficit.
Yes, yes, yes. Now, last question. You've done instrumentation and control. What do you study under this?
Ma'am, instrumentation and control is primarily a branch that deals with the measurement and control of process parameters in industry. Like temperature, pressure, etc. And their control. And nowadays, the next thing happening here is that we should go for automation. And human interference in the control process should be as less as possible.
Thank you.
Mr. Financial Action Task Force. What does it stand for? For the work it's role.
Sir, Financial Action Task Force is an intergovernmental body which was formed by some of the developed countries. I think around the 1990s. So primarily this task force is involved with taking action against those countries which have been promoting terrorism. And under this there are different lists like grey list, black list, which put certain restrictions on investment in such countries, which they designate as promoting terrorism.
There was a meeting of the FATF recently.
Yes,
what transpired in the meeting?
Sir, in the FATF meeting, Pakistan was put in the grey list. Again, it was in the grey list and India was pushing to put it under black list after the Pulwama terror attack. But it was
some
still
time, timeline has been set. What is the target date? By what time Pakistan has been asked to comply with certain things?
So I'm not aware about the exact date.
End of June. Okay. India's energy security, how do you look at that? Particularly the oil, the field of oil.
So, if we see India on a large scale now, we do have the foreign. If we see the energy security of India, then I would say that we are producing.
Is India's oil dependence a matter of concern for us?
Yes, it is a matter of concern because we are importing around 70-80% of our oil requirements.
Almost touching 85%.
And because of this, we have to bail out a lot of our forex reserves. And if there are any political problems in these countries, then it does affect our economic growth also. So it is a very important concern.
Domestic exploration of oil, what is the trend? Is there a decline or is it, are we doing enough?
Sir, I am not aware about the exact statistics, sir, but we are, many schemes are there, sir. We are doing a progress.
Is the world moving towards increasing protectionism?
Sir, yes, to some extent we are seeing protectionism.
What are these signals? Are there any signals?
Yes, sir. So if we see from past 50 years, we have seen Brexit. When we have seen the election of Honorable American President Donald Trump, that was...
No, election by itself is not indicative of protectionism. What action has he taken or intends to take, which will lead to increasing protection?
Sir, he's taking actions like he has started a trade war now. And apart from that, on the last thing, he is also putting his America First policy behind. So he's saying that America has taken a lot of efforts. And in the past, he has also withdrawn America from the Trans-Pacific Partnership. So all this shows some protections.
You mentioned of sugar problem in Maharashtra, right? Certain countries have challenged India in the WTO on giving subsidy to sugar. Are you aware of that?
Okay, sir, I have not read much about it.
Okay. This is Brazil and Australia. They have challenged India's subsidy to sugar before the WTO. Okay. What is diplomatic immunity?
Sir, diplomatic immunity means that when a particular diplomat is working in a foreign country, then he or she has certain amount of privileges over normal citizens. For instance, he cannot be prosecuted, he cannot be arrested.
Right, last question. Return of Wing Commander Abhinandan. Would you see it as a victory of India's diplomacy?
Sir, to some extent I would, because in the past few weeks, India is trying to isolate Pakistan, and it is pressurizing Pakistan by using countries like US, France, UK. However, sir, I also feel that under the Geneva Convention, Pakistan had to release him. So it is not much diplomatic victory for us. Pakistan would have done it in 2 days.
Now, Maharashtra has some very serious problems, facing some very serious problems currently. Can you identify some of them?
Sir, primarily I think currently Maharashtra's biggest problem is agrarian distress.
Mm-hmm.
Second problem is the inequality in Maharashtra, because barring the Mumbai-Pune region, on a large scale the rest of Maharashtra is quite underdeveloped. Sir, third major problem of Maharashtra I think is urbanization. Because around 45% of Maharashtra is urbanized, but the condition of cities is not very proper. Fourth problem, sir, is unemployment, and we could see its repercussion in the recent demand for reservation by the Maratha community. It was mostly because they do not have proper jobs. And lastly, sir, I also feel that environment is a major problem in Maharashtra, because only around 20-23% of Maharashtra's area is under forest, which is too less if we compare it with the national requirement of 33%.
Yes, quite right. But you forgot one very serious thing, is the drought.
Yes.
More than 300 talukas have been declared drought talukas already.
Yes, sir.
And it is only February. One doesn't know what will happen in the summer months.
Yes, sir.
They say that part of this water shortage in Maharashtra, faced by farmers, is man-made.
Yes, sir.
Of course, there is a shortage that there are, but part of it is man-made. Is that a correct statement?
Sir, to some extent it is correct, because if you really see, sugarcane is grown in Maharashtra, and that too in some places like Vidarbha, where water scarcity is quite high. So because of this, it is a man-made problem. But sir, I feel that it is more a natural problem, because around 80% Maharashtra is made up of Deccan Plateau, which is hard and consolidated. So whenever rainfall comes, the water just drains into the Bay of Bengal. It doesn't seep into ground. So naturally, irrigation potential in Maharashtra is too less. And that is the reason why Maharashtra has only around 18% of irrigated total agriculture area under irrigation. And secondly, sir, because Western Ghat comes in the middle, a large amount of winds that carry moisture do not reach Vidarbha and Marathwada region. So rainfall also is too less in the other parts of Maharashtra.
So you are giving a blank check to the sugar lobby. Yeah?
No.
They are responsible in search of, that is where the political power lies in Maharashtra, cooperative sugar.
Yes,
sir. And they take away 60% of the, there is imbalance, total imbalance.
on the
that is where something has to be done.
Yes.
Why did last time there was a farmers' march in Bombay? Not this time, but last about 6-7-8 months ago.
Yes, sir.
Why did they demand implementation of FRA? Farmers demanding FRA implementation.
So I'm not much aware about. So I think the tribals were demanding FRA.
Yes, because tribal lands are being taken away.
Yes, sir.
You go to Palghar, etc., a lot of places. Urbanites are coming and grabbing those lands. Now, lately there was a controversy about a judgment of the Supreme Court on implementation of FRA. Did you read that?
Yes, sir. It was a February 13 order of the Supreme Court.
What was it and what is the latest?
Sir, the Honorable Supreme Court on February 13 said that those tribals those tribals, after the assessment, they have been found not to have a right on the land which they are.
Those who are not entitled to land.
Yes, sir. So they have to be evacuated.
Must be immediately evacuated or ousted.
Yes, sir. That was there. And sir, 2 days back, the honorable.
So how many people were to be affected? How many people were to be ousted?
Sir, I do not know the exact number.
Almost 19 lakh, 1.9 million.
So
what is happening now?
Sir, 2-3 days back, many of the state governments approached the Honorable Court and
central government approached the central.
And now
there's
the
a
court
state,
has
the state court will review it.
Yes.
Reservation of Marathas. How much reservation do they have?
Sir, they have been given a 16%
reservation. 16%?
Yes.
So what is now total percentage of reservation? For people in Maharashtra, OBCs and SCs and STs, how much is the total?
So exact number I do not know, but
percentage.
Yes, sir. But sir, it has crossed 60%.
It has crossed 60%. So will it not come into conflict with the Indira Gandhi Sahni case?
So there are demands, and the court may review it. The Bombay High Court is actually reviewing the reservation. And it may come in conflict with the Indira Sahni judgment.
It definitely will come, why? Right?
Because sir, in the Indira Sahni judgment, the Honorable Court said
this is at 60%, 50%.
50%.
Therefore, it is bound to come.
Yes.
And so, what defense does the state government have? How will it save this reservation?
Sir, primarily they are giving...
Think of the constitutional provisions. And the what constitutional provision they would like to save it?
So, maybe they will save it by saying that the Marathas are economically backward. And now the parliament has also made an
constitutional provision.
Sir, maybe Article 16, 16.4.
9 should be. Have you heard of 9 should be? Have you heard of it or not?
But, sir, I don't think that they can lose 9 should be because the court, Honorable Court has said that if any judgment after. If any law after 1973 is put in it, then it is going to be reviewed.
Correct. Very good. In fact, 9th schedule was created to oust judicial review.
Yes.
But Supreme Court in Coelho case, have you heard of Coelho case? In 2007, has laid down any law which disturbs the basic structure will still be subject to review. There are some enforceable provisions which promote social justice. Part 3 of the Constitution. Identify those provisions. Articles.
So, one of the articles is Article 14. It talks of the right to equality.
Just give the articles.
Article 14, Article 15, then Article 16, also 17, 18.
Good, very excellent.
Then Article 21 and 22.
22 are for police.
Article 29 and 30.
What about 23, 24?
Yes, sir. Yes. Related to trafficking of women's children and bonded people.
and child labor, bounty labor. There are some important issues pending before Supreme Court. If you are reading the newspapers about current affairs, you should be able to highlight those issues. Only tell the issues which are pending before Supreme Court. Name some important ones.
Sir, I think one is the Ayodhya judgment.
Good.
Second, I think Sabarimala is pending.
Sabarimala is practically over. What else? Very important issues. Rafal?
Yes.
Rafal has been revived?
Yes, sir.
What else? NRC?
Yes, sir.
Are you sure? Do you know about NRC, Supreme Court's directive?
No. But, sir, the Supreme Court has said that we should.
Police encounters in UP? 10% reservation for EWS?
Yes, sir.
Low part? Very important. If you're reading newspapers, only then you know. Why did Trump and Kim summit fail? Very briefly.
So primarily it is on the definition of denuclearization. Because President Trump and America wants complete denuclearization.
What does Kim want?
Mr. Kim is not in complete favor of denuclearization. He wants a regime stability. That America should ensure the stability and security.
So what did Kim put forward, demand, and what America did? Any idea you haven't read?
No, sir, I'm not reading so much.
Never mind. Now we close the interview. I'm giving you a feedback. So, Neil, you've done very well. You have handled most questions very nicely. You have a very crazy personality. Everything is in your. Your concepts are very clear, like you said, how you will introduce constitution to the foreigner. So you will start with the preamble. Absolutely correct. Now most questioning will be based the way we have tried to frame our questions. Maharashtra is one. Second, political science and international affairs. Third, instrumentation and control. In this you talked of automation. Yourself you talk.
Yes,
so you should think of the use of robots, etc. now in the field. In India, how much application of automation has taken place. That can be, it will be your strong point. And then, constitutional principles, we have asked you a number of them. Important current affairs, including issues before Supreme Court. Which I have just told you everything. And lastly, foreign service issues, because foreign service is your first choice.
Yes.
So, this is a strengthen the lijiya of your knowledge. But time come here. For instance, our claim to UNSCC, MNC, don't go into that history. India, one of the largest nations in the world. Among the largest. Yeah.
Sir,
territory-wise, economy, as well as demography. We carry a big weight in world affairs.
Sir,
and therefore, that is
nuclear power.
Don't talk of nuclear power. Just because nuclear power, then tomorrow North Korea will also ask for a seat. Because of our weight in world affairs, in economy, military, and demography, trade, we are a very big nation. So, ispara tayari kariye.
Yes. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Good luck.
Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel, and press the bell icon to never miss an update.